Good morning, everybody. Today is a new day, and I told you last night that my sister and I are going geocaching, and we're starting off our journey at the Dover Dam. Let me show you what the Dover Dam is. It's the Dover Dam. This is my sister. Her name's Lorette.
Hey.
Hi, Lorette.
Hey, George.
So, about geocaching. Geocaching is something that's worldwide, and it's the funnest thing. Basically, people take a container and hide it, and you hide it anywhere. And it's usually on, it has to be on public property. If you want to hide a geocache on somebody's private property, you have to have permission, but mostly they're on private public property like this. We're at the dam here. There's a geocache that we're going to find, and I'll take you along as we search for it. But a person will hide the geocache. It's in a container. Inside of each container, there's a logbook so that you can sign your name, sign the date when you found it. Sometimes people put little trinkets and stuff in it just because people are on travels from all around the world, and they'll leave something inside of the container. And then you can take something if you want and leave something of your own. Or just, we just like to sign the logbook. And then we always get on the geocaching site and log in that we found it. And I think the last time I checked, I had 200 maybe that I found so far, maybe. And you have probably 600 or something. I don't know. Something crazy. But we used to be in a contest to see who could find the most. But she's way ahead of me because I haven't been geocaching in a long time. But it's a lot of fun. And,
There's a free app.
Yes, because you really do need some type of GPS, because when they hide the geocache, they log in the coordinates, and then you have to type in the coordinates on your GPS, and you basically follow the coordinates until you find the area that the geocache is in, and they'll give you hints, like it's behind a tree or in a hole of a tree or something.
I'm stumped,
yes. Some of them say that. So then you know that probably in a stump. So some of the clues are very, very vague, though. And there's different difficulty levels. Like, some of the geocaches are very easy to find. Some of them are medium. And some of them are very hard. And we've had some where we've searched literally for, hours, probably. So, but we're going to find this one, and we'll take you along with us. And
we're 128 feet away from it.
We're 128 feet right now from it. So
the app is called Geocaching Intro. It's free.
There is
one that's $9.99, but some of the caches are not available with the free one. But this one's good enough.
Okay.
130 feet this way.
130 feet that way?
Yep.
All right. So I'm going to follow. She's going to use the GPS and lead us to the area that it's in. You can also use, I have a GPS, a regular Garmin GPS that I take along with me that maps your coordinates and everything.
We are getting close.
Let's see, we are getting close, and it tells you are getting close.
We're 30 feet away from our geocache.
We're now 30 feet away. Okay, taking you along. Let's see what's in front of us.
Geocaching says it's probably in this one.
How far does it say we are?
13 feet.
We're 13 feet away.
So I would say check this thing.
Okay, we'll check around here. I'm going to walk this way. I got the hiccups. Again. And it'll also tell you what size of a geocache it is. Sometimes people will tell you it's in a peanut butter jar container, because those are waterproof, or they can make them waterproof. And So some of them are larger containers, some of them are smaller. Excuse me. So I'm going to look around this area right here. Sometimes they're under rocks, like you can see here. There's a lot of rocks here. And so sometimes you just need to move things around. Excuse me. That's ridiculous. Sometimes you need to move things around a little bit. To find them. But you just never know. But it's a treasure hunt and it's really cool. Alright, it wasn't in those rocks, so I'm going back this way. And it doesn't tell you specifically where things are, but you always just look. And sometimes they're even magnets that are stuck, like, to the guardrail or whatever, metal parts and things. I found it. I don't know if you can see it in there. We're right here in the guardrail. This is the guardrail on the street. We found our first geocache today. Take it out of there. It's a little container.
Has a log.
Log book.
They're all different sizes.
I just told them that.
Oh.
That's okay.
We'll just cut that
out. I repeat myself probably like 50 times a day, so.
Oh my goodness.
So yeah, there's a log book, and we always sign the log book. And sometimes
you have to cut out some of that stuff.
They keep things in plastic just so in case water gets in. But this is so cool. And it's amazing to see the people that sign some of these. They're from California or Arizona, all over the world, all over the United States and the world. And you always write what date.
So the first date here is from there. What's that? June 20th of 2014. And the last person found it on the 24th.
Okay, a few days ago somebody found this one. So
I'm going to sign my name.
And then after you sign it, put everything back. You always put everything back the way you found it. Wrap everything back up, close the lid, and then we're going to put it back in the exact same spot that it was in, so that somebody else can find it again. It's a cool treasure hunt. Was there any trinkets in there?
Yeah.
What's in there? Chips, a dime, a nickel, a fuse.
And a fake bug.
And a fake bug in there.
But I'm not going to take anything.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, I'm not taking anything today. Unless somebody leaves like $1 million in one.
Yeah, we'll take that.
Yeah, we'll take that. Cool. We got our first cache today. Do you want to say something?
No.
You want to say something to the camera?
No.
Did you have something more to add to it?
No.
You can... So we just started our journey looking for the geocaches, and you have to know that my sister and
things.
I lose a lot of things. Very forgetful, and we're searching. We're searching very hard for her keys. She's got her other car keys, but not the car keys to the vehicle we have today. And
but I just had them.
I didn't tell her yet, but I actually found her keys.
Wait. How did you find my keys?
Well, I don't know, but somehow you left them in the door.
No.
All right. So,
here
we go. We're off to our next geocache. How many things will we forget or lose today? Okay, we're at our destination to do some more geocaching. There's like 30 geocaches along this trail. We're at Fort Lawrence Park in Bolivar, Ohio. And this is a beautiful trail. Take a look at it. It's all wooded, so it's nice and shaded and nice and cool in here. This is what I wanted to talk to you guys about. Getting out and doing things. You know, I sat around in my chair for a year and a half, 2 years there, doing nothing, not doing my geocaching or working out. And I miss doing this stuff, so, and I love it. I love coming out here and just being out in nature, so that's why I want to motivate you to get out and do things like this. This trail is like 15 minutes from my house, and you can spend the day or half a day here walking. This is an actually nice, pretty much flat trail compared to the what we were on yesterday, the cliffs and the hills and stuff, but we're just here to geocache, and but yeah, get out and do something. Get out and have fun, exercise. This is a lot of exercise today, so all right, we're gonna get started.
Okay, I just found it. She doesn't know it. She's back there looking, but I found it in this tree. I just happened to notice it is... Bam!
Awfully suspicious.
There it is. Our second geocache today. The really cool thing about geocaching is it's a family activity. Something you can take your whole family to do. Just spend the day, have a picnic, go out geocaching, and spend the day out in nature. It's really fun. It really is. And it's surprising how not very many people even know about geocaching. And the crazy thing is that the geocaches, they're not just out on trails. They're everywhere. They're in the middle of cities. And you walk by geocaches every single day, and you don't even know it. They're right in front of you. They're under trash cans or just behind trees in cities or in, you know, like that one inside of a hole. But you don't even know it, but you walk by them every single day. All right, keep going here. You're fast.
5 feet to go?
Okay, I just wanted to show you guys how this works. I've got my geocaching app here. This is a free app, like my sister said. We've already found this first one. Now we're gonna go to this next one. They're all in green dots, so I'm gonna click on it. It kinda highlights. Then you go down and you hit start. And it tells me right here, we are 0.3 miles away from this one. And right here is a little compass in the middle. And as you get closer, let's see, as you get closer, it will tell you you're getting closer and how close you are. So that's how the GPS works on this. All right, Lorette found this one, and it's a big, huge tree. And this is kind of steep.
A little steep. A lot of sap.
This one is actually hanging on the tree. So we're gonna go ahead and get this one. And we're getting close to this one. And it's in here somewhere. I see it. See how somebody walking on the trail would never see this? It's so small and just hidden. There's so much foliage around. It's just hidden. I can tell that all the ones that we're finding so far are placed by the same person because they're all the same containers. So this person did a lot of work here on this trail placing geocaches. Where are you going?
Well, this is 28 feet. But...
28 feet?
Yeah.
You think you're going the right way?
Yeah.
You're sure? Like, can you guys see it? It's right there, hanging on the tree. You don't see it?
Yes.
All right, we found like our sixth one today. Okay, we're close to another one here, and she's gonna search for this one, but there are several locks along this towpath trail. This is Lock 7. It used to be part of the canal. You can see a picture of the canal boat and the lock there. This is hard to see here, but this is really cool because all the locks are still here that the boats used to travel through. It's
pretty deep. It's probably at least 20, I don't know, 20, 30 feet deep maybe down there. But yeah, that's how the boats used to travel along the canal ways. Pretty cool. All right, did you find it?
No.
One of the reasons, well, my sister started geocaching and then I started doing it after she did, was it brings you to places that you probably would never normally go to and never normally see. And we've seen so many places over the years geocaching that are such cool places and just fun things, fun ways to spend the day doing. And just the hunt for the treasure, even though it's not a treasure, it's something to do while you're hiking. And this goes along with what I said about changing up things and doing your workout different. We're still getting a good workout here. We're walking fast, but we're finding these geocaches along the way. So it's a fun game. Those people were really nice. They were asking questions about geocaching. They had never heard of it before. Yeah, it's cool. It's cool to meet people, too. You meet a lot of people when you're out doing this. All right, we are 0 for 2 for the last two now. We've been searching and searching. Sometimes they're just really hard to find. And we have looked all over. And I am guessing right now that tomorrow I'm going to be covered in poison ivy. And totally forgot about this. There's poison ivy everywhere. So I used to not get poison ivy at all, but now I get it so easily. But it's kind of frustrating when you're not able to find these, because you just, once you get started, you want to find them all. And kind of sucks, but it's just what happens. Sometimes you don't find them. And then there's so many on this trail, we're just going to keep moving on and trying to find, I don't even know if I'm filming myself, try and find the next one. And it is actually in this tree, and I had to walk through briars to get around to it. And they are in my legs and in my side. But here it is.
The dedication of a geocache.
Yes, it takes dedication to do this.
There's poison ivy.
There's poison ivy and there's bugs, and we just found another one behind a tree. Same kind of container, so it's the same person putting this one here. Awesome. I think we found, what, 8 now? 7?
Who knows?
Something like that.
There's lots of mosquitoes.
Yeah, I did not bring spray. And we just found our last geocache for the day. And look what I have to reach through to get this thing. Poison ivy. And I've already got it all over my arm, so I guess it doesn't matter, but I'm gonna get it, and I'm gonna get poison ivy. There it is. Have fun. Let's see, the poison ivy will be starting very soon. My hands are itchy, my wrists are itchy, everything's itchy. Ugh. All right, we're on our way back. We've had a good day of geocaching. I think we found, how many did we find?
I'm not sure.
We're not sure. Probably, I don't know, 10 or maybe somewhere around 10. There's a lot more. There's a few more miles on this trail, but we're just, we got to get back now. We got things to do today. And so hope you enjoyed this, and I hope you guys check out geocaching. What is it? Is it geocaching.com?
Yep.
That's the website. Go there and look it up, and it's in every state, 180 countries. And it's a really fun thing to do. So have a great day, guys, and don't step in that horse shit.
Got it.
Got
keep
it?
Keep moving.
Something stinks. All right. I will see you guys tomorrow. Remember, do a good deed. Give somebody a compliment. Be motivational. Be positive. And be an inspiration to somebody. Talk to you guys later.
right back. We had a great day. It was a fun day. And we got some exercise. And now it's time for lunch. So,
walked about 3 miles.
3 miles. At a good pace.
So, probably maybe 8, 9, 10 geocaches somewhere.
Yeah.
In that region.
Somewhere in that region. Yep. All right. I'm glad you guys got to meet my sister. And you'll see her again sometime. Have a great day, guys. Bye.